might not be able to tell it on the phone, but there is definitely a nice bass to this. So give it a bit of thrash and shut it down again. First of all, we'll have a cold start. And we'll, as we're putting some stock, go into heavy mode, toot the whistle. Sorry, the whistle, and off we go. Function 9 is for the flange squeal, which changes on the what we're doing. Braking is on F2. What else we got? Okay, got spirit valves, which I've got thrown on. Shut it down. Got a fuel priming pump. Got various air compressors. Two different types, three different stocks. We've got Gars whistle, door opening and closing, coupling up, uncoupling, and new to the sound project compared to the other one I've got, we now have radio transmission between the shunter and the driver. They're operated in sequence if you want to, or you can just play about with them. And they are on function 19 to function 26. So 19 is shunting lights, which pull forward a little bit. Okay, that's, as you can see, they've got both red lights on. That's standard directional. When we're doing some proper shunting, we need to put the shunt lights on, which is function 19. he says, and it's not working. That's clever, isn't it? Sorry. 19 is a cab light. Oh dear. 10. Right, there we go. So we've got a here light. I can't actually see that. Let's move the camera. There we go. So you've got a white and a red. Right, where are we? Okay, back to the audio. So the audio is basically 20 to 26. As follows. There you go. Like with all pool chatter sounds, you have control of locomotive with the train, which is what it's been doing. We go into the actual shunting mode. The inertia of the loco is different now, so it's a bit quicker. Uncoupling and coupling up. There's a buffer sound as well, which is activated automatically as the engine moves around. But that's a quick overview of what the pool chatter sound chip can do from Digitrains. Bye.